This is just my Hummingbird Carousel. I made it around 2 months ago. I'm really happy for it, even though it sometimes fails. But basically, this is almost the same thing as scratch. It's used about the same way. And this is just a really basic one, so when I press the left arrow, it should start spinning. Yeah. And my favorite thing about it is that I can press up and it'll stop it. And then if I just erase that, I could make it go slower like this. If I press 25, or I can make it go really fast, even though it's probably gonna fall off with 100. Okay. And then yeah. I'm really happy for this. And along with that, there's the lights. There's this, which is the quad-colored light, which is this monster of a thing that's basically only used to make this light blink a little bit. If you want to come in sight and see better, you can. And if I, this bottom number, I don't know if you can see what I was getting again. This bottom number, since it's 1550, it'll stop on like purplish. If I add this, which is zero on everything, it should just be black. But, yeah, great. No, I put it in the wrong spot. Oh no. But yeah, it should just change to become zero. Or it should just be changed to become black. Mm-hmm. And along with that, there's the regular color, which is just this, since it only has two. And if I press the space bar, this should just be red, but it's a really boring red. It doesn't really have like really super bright. But if you want to come up and see this easier, it's really fun. I basically made this so you could make it either, like, you could change which way it spins. And if I put these two cords in, which are the orange, which are the motor, I can change which side they're in so that it will spin a different way. So right now, I think it spins counterclockwise. But if I change which direction these cords are in, it should spin regular clockwise. Yep, it changes direction. I can change any of these colors at any time, and it all depends on, for like if this one right here, if I make this one 50 for everything, then it'll just be this color. But if I only make it 100 green and 0, if I make it 100 green and 0 else, then it'll just be green, or if I do that with any of the other colors, it should. You have the wrong thing, but you understand that. Okay. Any questions?
Gavin, do you want to tell them how you began? You had to teach yourself that.
Oh, yeah.
How did you begin?
The first way, or the first thing that I started doing with this was looking up other people's projects, not to copy, but more so because it showed me how this works, because they don't really explain it extremely well in this because they want you to do it yourself. Does anybody want one of these that we can read through all this? I wasn't sure because some people wouldn't, I'm not sure. But I basically read other people's directions that showed that if you just put the motor, the first number right here corresponds to which one of these because there's two motors. And if I made this one like it is now and then I press the button, it'll go. If I change it to 2 and then press the button, 3. Stop it first, and then if I press it, then it doesn't go at all because it's the wrong number. Same thing with all the lights, and that's how it is for all of them. I didn't know that at first, so it was really confusing. But there's only two of these, so I can make it 1 or 2. And if I made all of these 2, then when I press the down arrow, it just wouldn't light up. I built this. I mostly just built this to hold it up and show it. But there's one part right here, and this is the part that was the hardest. I had to make sure that this could connect to this, which is what this blue piece is here for, and then I had to hot glue all of these together so that when it spanned, it didn't, like the problem before was that when it spanned, instead of spinning the whole thing, it would just go like back and forth. So I had to glue all of these pieces together so that it would look like this. And now I have this carousel. I really, really, really like the Hummingbird because you can do so many different things with it. And I'm not 100% sure, but Makey Makey thing they did last, I'm pretty sure you can do with this because it has the same down arrow, up arrow, left arrow, and right arrow. So I'm really excited to try that out. This keyboard is, or this board itself has two areas for tricolors, which are the four wires, has four areas for the two colors, which is the regular LEDs, and it has these sensors, which I didn't understand what they did first, but you could talk or blow, or like if one of them has light on it, then it just won't do anything, but whenever it's dark, it will continue going, and then these vibrators. If I attach one of those to this, then it would shake back and forth. And because of the fact that there's two motors, you can make this spin itself, and then if I put a second motor right here, then I can make it spin the opposite way. That would be really cool.
Do you want to show them the HummingBird kit that's inside?
Yeah. The kit itself, it came with one of these, and then it came with two extras, which is really good. It came with a bunch of these, and these are the motors themselves. They come in little boxes like this. And it came with three of the tricolors, so it has extra. This is one of the sensors, and if it's like moving at all, then it won't spin at all, but if it stops moving, then it'll spin. This is the light sensor, where if you shine light on it or anything, then it will stop, but if there's no light, then it goes. And then this is an extra motor. This is the vibrator itself that makes it actually vibrate, and it, if you put it on 100, then it goes like super crazy. Probably break if I leave it on for too long. Yeah. I'm gonna pass this one so you can see it. Oops. Along with the fact, I'm really excited with this because the way I put the connect pieces together, they can move freely independently of each other. So put it in. It should be able to go all by itself, and then you can tap any of the pieces and they will also come.
Gavin, would there be a way to use the making with this and make it make sound as, at the same time as it turns?
Yes.
Hummingbird have sounds? Or?
I don't know if Hummingbird itself has sounds, but I know that it can work on the computer. And the fact that, I don't know where it is, but I think it's in there somewhere. What was it called? Oh yeah, in this, there's all of these where there's motion, which is motors, vibrators, and the servo. There's control, which is all the orange pieces. You can tell based on the color. It can, you can either make it go forever, or you can make it repeat however many times you want to. There's looks, which is things like lights, or I think that's about it. There's sensing, which is the sensors for if you're touching it or if the light is touching it, and that would make it turn on and off. There's sound, which is, I think, what's it called? Sound. And when it changes sound, I think like, you can change the
sound. So you can have it with one direction and make one sound if you reverse it and make another sound.
For operators, this is just a whole mess of stuff. There's so many different things. Like you can make it this way, this certain amount of connector go, or if it stops. The pen is mostly just for this area, like you can make it draw things. And the variables are things like if it moves left, then it will go up or down.
So those are probably depending on what your robot or what your project is.
Oh, some of the projects that you can do, and it's more complex than this, which isn't that too much different, but you can make, somebody made one that I saw, which is how I figured out how to get the motor to work. They made it, they made like an arm, and if you pressed the right arrow, then it would go up, and then if you press left, it would move down. And then using the vibrators, you can make one of those little things where it's just like a paper triangle, and then it vibrates and like it moves forward. That's really cool. Or if I take all of these, it would take a really long time to do it, but if you take all these lights, you can connect them into each other or onto each other. So I can connect all of these onto this so that not only would it spin, but it would also shine all the lights different colors.
What are some obstacles you ran into?
One of the really difficult things was in these, it's when I tell you do everything, it's some of the things you can do, but it's really like it makes you do like everything on your own, so it isn't very, like if you're doing it for your first time, it's not extremely easy. But once you get into it, it's really, really, really fun. For the HummingBird motor, I had no idea what this number or this number meant at all. So I made this one like 50 and this one was the one, and it didn't work, so I was just really confused. And then for all of these, I didn't know this at first because it was probably like a different if you're going to use it. The red light is positive, and then the black light or the black wire is always a negative. And if you don't put these in, like it says red, green, blue, and a negative for all the colors of wires. And if you don't have the wires in the right position or like shape, then they will not go no matter what.
Didn't we talk about that, like a car when you're charging
the
car,
you
have to have the right cables.
Another thing is that if I replace this repeat with Go Forever, then I, this is all the stuff. If I replaced it with Forever, it would just go on forever. If I put that there, then if I put the motor in the Forever and just had it like go, it would spin forever even if I unplug the USB, which I think is really cool. Because it sends the signal to this, which then sends it to the motor or the lights. So I think that if I press that now, I can unplug the USB and it should keep going. Yeah. None of the other things do that except for the motor. I'm really excited that I found that out because now I can do something like if I just plug it in and went, and I wouldn't have to carry around a giant bulky computer all the time. I think that's really cool.
That is crazy.
Mm-hmm.
So is that where maybe a sensor would come in?
Like the sensor would work with that too, where if you send it, then all the information is stored on this. So if you send, like if you press the left arrow and the left arrow is like, keep going on forever, and that's where these variables go, or where the variables come in. So like if you had it for the show or hide, then that you make it set, it'll keep going on forever, but if something happens, it'll stop, and if that thing moves out of the way, then it'll keep going. And it's really interesting to try to just go and do whatever you want, because you can make basically anything you should ever want, so basically anything you can do with this, because it's just all pure imagination.
This hurts my heart so much.
Does anybody have any questions? Or does anybody want to like try to design?
What class did you do that in?
This? During our 8th hour, which is our final hour of the day, we just kind of, it's usually a free hour, I either have a band or a free hour, and when I just was like, I didn't really have much to do, so I asked Mrs. Flanagan if I could do this instead, or like something fun like this, and I've been doing this since I think about February, and it's been so much fun just doing this over and over again, because it sounds like it would be really boring, but it's actually pretty fun because you can make so many different things. One of the first things that I made was basically just like a bare bones like piece of paper. I think it was like, it was about a V shape, like on 2 points, and then I put one of the vibrators on it, and I learned that from one of the online things that they have. They have a HummingBird website, and when I attached the vibrator, then it started moving. And for most people who are outside, it doesn't seem that, like, outside of it, it doesn't seem that, like, impressive or anything. But when you spend all this time building something and then finally seeing it work, it's so interesting. It makes you feel really good.
What background do you have in coding before you got
this? I had no background in coding. Like, I never did coding before this. But it's once you figure out, like, if you look up, like, on the website, it shows you how to do all these different things. So once you find out how to do it, it's really fun and really interesting. It's kind of hard at first, but once you get into it, it's so much fun just figuring out all these different combinations that you can do.
Yeah, did you do
code
that
or did you ship it out? We did that, but that was not very much like this. It was basically, that was more just like, this is the color that you want it to go to. This is like really fun.
This is a little more advanced than the same way you got to.
I think it would be really fun to do at any time because this itself looks like it would take hours or it would take like super hard. I guess in like 5 minutes, the only really difficult thing is making sure it's all in the right order. It's really fun to do just like whenever you have free time.
So what did you use to make the carousel? What kind of pieces?
Oh,
I didn't quite catch it.
Oh,
yeah.
I used Connect pieces, which are really fun to use. And this part did not come with it. I think this took me like a things. It's really small, but it took about 20 minutes because I had to put all these pieces in the right order so I could hook on and spin without spinning the wrong way. Sorry for repeating myself, but it's hard not to because when you spend this much time on something, then you finally get it to work. It's so exciting. It's really fun.
You kind of have to make it work.
Yeah.
With the motor, right, Gavin? Is that where you said that you kind of had to tweak the
for this motor, pieces? The reason that there's like rainbow and technicolor of all these zip ties is because for the motor to work, it has to be elevated, and it wasn't elevated at first. So I basically zip tied it in so that it would be able to like float. And for these pieces right here, since they aren't actually connected, I had to cross-hatch two zip ties, which is basically just crossing it with two zip ties and pulling them really tight so it would stick together. And now, it's like a bridge, and then this cord that goes over, since it's held up by this thing's weight, then it won't fall down.
I've seen people just take cardboard and make a robot. I think that's on a HummingBird site, and they just make a robot out of cardboard and use the HummingBird to move it and leave the island.
Like if you had like a piece of cardboard and this was against it and then there was like a hole in it, you could attach something to it that would make like if it spins right then it would go like the arm would go up or down. I don't know what you said earlier. And
yeah.
It's so much fun to just build all those things. Mm-hmm. Yeah. This is how I did it. I basically went onto the App Store, or the App Store, and then there's this, which is the HummingBird Connection app. And when you click it, it just goes to, you can either open Scratch or Snap, which are pretty similar. And then you just open it, and it just brings you to this.
And you're doing Snap?
Mm-hmm. I do the Snap because it's a lot easier, and it's like, you can save it on Snap, but you can't save it on Scratch. And then, yeah.
You should be able to save it on Scratch.
I think you can save it on Scratch, but then you have to save it onto this, onto your computer itself. Or you have to save it onto
transfer it over there.
They have these, which are small bracelets, and they have an SD thing in. And if you want to save it for the Snap or for the Scratch, then you have to save it onto one of these. And I did not want to end up saving it onto one of these and losing it. Fun.
Gotcha. I think you can snap last year, right?
Next thing that I really wanted to make was last year somebody made a Ferris wheel. And I kind of wanted to make one too because it was really interesting to watch it unfold and then start going itself. It's just
really
I'd rather have something that can move instead of something that's just stable. Like this, because when it moves, then it kind of like stability and makes it feel like it was working. Yeah.